My name is Andrew Garner, and my climate change film will be a documentary discussing the issue of changing climate and its severe effects on coral reefs. Coral reefs are one of the most biodiverse ecosystems on the planet. They are home to thousands of different species of marine plants, animals, and organisms that make up 25% of all marine life. Here are some quick representations of healthy coral reefs versus bleached coral reefs, resulting from climate change and higher sea temperatures.
Oh, hello. I was just enjoying the coral reefs of South Florida for maybe one of the last times. Sadly, much of it is bleached, like this coral head here. In the past decade, we have lost more than 14% of the world's coral reefs. You're probably asking yourself, why has this happened? The primary reason has been rising sea temperatures. These rising temperatures are caused by increased greenhouse gas emissions, which cause mass bleaching and death of coral. According to the World Economic Forum, the ocean absorbs over a quarter of all CO2 emissions and 90% of the excess heat produced by these emissions. This has caused severe damage to fragile ecosystems like coral reefs. Let's head to the lab and put this into perspective with some recent data.
So, TheGuardian.com says between 1971 and 2018, the ocean had gained 396 zettajoules of heat. Scientists have calculated it is the equivalent energy of more than 25 billion Hiroshima atomic bombs, and that heat gain is only accelerating. So this graph here shows the average water temperature anomaly has been increasing consistently since the 1970s. The indicator line in the center represents the average water temperature from 1971 to 2000. So it's used as a reference to show the modern increases and variations above that average, which are shown up here. You can see that since the late 1980s, the temperatures have been consistently above the previous average, and you can see they're above the line. And they're continually rising after year over year to 1 degrees Fahrenheit above that average. Remember that late 1980s date that I just mentioned because it will tie in closely with what I'm about to show you in the next graph. This next graph represents the percentage of reefs worldwide that have experienced mass bleaching and mass deaths since 1982. This is based on degree heating weeks, and according to the NOAA, a degree heating week is equal to 1 week of sea surface temperature 1 degree Celsius above the expected summertime maximum. For example, 2 degree heating weeks indicate 1 week of 2 degrees Celsius above the expected summertime maximum. In this graph, 4 degree heating weeks represents mass bleaching, and 8 degree heating weeks represents mass death. So now, remember that date I told you to remember? It was the late 1980s. Also, remember that the last graph's temperature indicator began to consistently exceed that 1970 to 2000 average in the late 1980s. Well, in this chart, the late 1980s show a spike in both bleaching and deaths, and that's shown here. And as the temperature from the last graph continues to increase, so do the deaths and bleaching represented here. Because in the late 1980s on the last graph, the temperature started increasing, and as you can see, both bleaching and deaths increase here. So, as you can see, by 2017, over 50% of the reefs worldwide experienced bleaching, and over 20% experienced some form of mass death.
So, how exactly does the increasing sea temperature cause coral to bleach and die? Well, it comes down to a symbiotic relationship between coral and algae. Healthy coral heads have microscopic algae called zooxanthellae living in them. This is what gives coral the vibrant and distinct colors you see when snorkeling or watching a National Geographic documentary. The algae provides the coral with food through photosynthesis, while the coral provide the algae with a place and structure to live. As ocean temperatures rise due to climate change, corals become stressed and their food-producing algae is expelled into the water, causing the corals to revert back to their natural white color, aka bleaching. Without algae, the corals lack a primary food source,
And if the algae do not return, the corals eventually die. And this looks like a bleached coral, and this isn't real, but it's just a model. And here I found some examples of bleached coral, and you could see all that's left is the calcium carbonate structure after all the zooxanthellae were expelled.
The body temperature rises 1 degree centigrade or 2 degrees centigrade. Over a period of time, that would be fatal. And that's the seriousness of the issue when you look at it in terms of the ocean.
You forget what it looked like at the beginning. And some days when you go back, it's dead as far as you can see.
I thought we would find bleaching. I thought we would capture it. But I don't think I ever prepared myself or thought we were gonna see this.
So this graph shows the observed water temperatures in July of this past year. And so just this past year in Florida, record temperatures were observed in the coastal waters. A study was conducted in July where temperatures at South Florida reefs were measured at 91 degrees on July 6th. The coral was completely healthy then, but when scientists returned over 2 weeks later, all the coral was bleached and over 80% of it was dead. Another report from the Coral Restoration Foundation found that 100% coral mortality was found at Sombrero Reef off the coast of Marathon Key in South Florida. And as you can see, temperatures increased to over 101 degrees. That's just as hot as your hotel hot tub.
In conclusion, you can now see that almost all these bleaches are contributed to climate change, and more specifically, the rising temperatures due to increased carbon emissions. If we do not reduce the greenhouse gas being released into our environment, the oceans will continue to act as a carbon sink and absorb the excess heat, ultimately destroying coral reef ecosystems. Restoration projects, like the artificial reefs pictured above, are attempting to offset the decrease in coral populations by instigating new growth in biodiversity, but they are struggling to keep up. Hopefully, projects like these and increased protective legislation will help combat this serious climate change issue before we lose our reefs for good.